This video is all about coils. I had a request to tell something about coils, and that's a big issue. Coils, their properties, their frequency dependent characteristics, saturation, quality factor. So it's almost impossible to do this video in a short time. I've made some notes here, things to tell about coils. Here are different functions from coils. Radio coils. This one is a radio coil. This one also. These ones also. Choke coils. Filter coils. Magnetic tape head coils. A coil in an old school video recorder. It's also a coil with certain properties. I put down the camera now. And these are old school magnetic coils that I've salvaged from tape recorders, video recorders, this one for instance. All these coils were made for certain aims, certain properties, to do something, and that's also the issue here. So, choke coils, filter coils, magnetic tape head, transformers. We've also many transformers. I don't have an example at the moment, but okay. Transformers for high frequency is also possible, and EF transformers, so for an intermediate frequency. I want to show them now. Take some time. This is, for instance, a transformer for an intermediate frequency from 10.7 megahertz. Made by Philips. And here we have a transformer for 460 kilohertz. Also made by Philips. I've tested these transformers, and especially to find out the pin connections. But anyway, radio coils, that was the first issue. Here we have some radio coils. They are wound on a toilet roll, covered with glue for PVC, for sewage pipes, inside and out. Outside this roll was covered. It was wound completely with telephone wire. That's plastic wire with a copper core in it. And the plastic insulates perfectly, keeps the coil without moisture, and keeps a sort of spacing. And the spacing between the windings here gives the coil a good quality factor. This is what quality factor means. It has a high peak on a certain frequency. For instance, on the central frequency here, 6 megahertz, it has a high peak, and on 5 and 7 megahertz, there's no high peak. That's something to tell about the quality factor. I can tell a lot more about it. There are also formulas to calculate the quality factor, but I think that is not necessary to tell in this video. So a radio coil here, but there are of course many other coils. Here also a radio coil with a ferrite rod. You can take it out, put it in, change the inductance and thus the frequency. So This is a brief explanation of radio coils. Here you see a radio coil made for medium wave and short wave. It is wound with Litzer wire. Litzer wire means approximately 30 very thin wires, all isolated and wound together, and that all has to do with the phenomena from the so-called skin effect. With Litzer wire there is less skin effect, and that means that the Q, the quality factor, goes up. You can find more info about the skin effect, as far as I know, on Wikipedia. So, this was a brief explanation about radio coils. We go now to the choke coils, the second from the notification. These are choke coils, and the property from a choke coil is that it has a low DC resistance but a high AC resistance. So we can damp out certain frequencies. That all depends on the frequency band where the choke coil was made for. A choke coil often has a magnetic core made from ferrite or iron. And how it works is this. This is the choke coil, the core. The DC resistance is low, but the AC resistance is frequency dependent, and that is this formula: frequency in hertz, inductance in Henry. Quite unusable values, but whatever. So the AC resistance here for this coil, for instance, for such a coil, differs completely from the DC resistance and is frequency dependent. So on, for instance, 1 MHz, you will find a high resistance, and at the same time, when you want to send a DC DC power through that coil, there is a low resistance. And in radio circuits, this is often used. For instance, here we have the positive lead to the tube, we can supply the tube with a DC voltage, say 200 volts. That works properly. But at the same time, we have here a high frequency circuit. For instance, when this is a radio tube, so we have here, say, 1 MHz. And at the same time, we can take out that high frequency, 1 MHz. And at the same time not disturbing the positive lead, so that the signals, the AC here, 1 MHz, does not travel on the power supply line. So that's why this coil is called a choke coil. It chokes the high frequencies, but it lets pass the DC voltage and the DC current. These coils are, by the way, usable for such an application. So let's go now to the to this circuit. It's a very high frequency tuner, VHF tuner. You can see the capacitors here, and the coils are also visible here and here, but it's necessary to say that such a VHF tuner is completely made within certain parameters regarding the distances. For instance, here, this part, this piece of wire here, is a coil on a certain frequency, and that can be calculated 1 centimeter or 2 centimeters. There is a relation to the wavelengths. That's important to know. And this is the capacitor, and here we have, for instance, in this case, a choke coil, but you can see that on this very, very high frequency, perhaps 300 megahertz or so, this coil is made with a very low inductance. It consists of only a few turns. And you can also see that we have here shielded compartments where all the amplifier units work, or oscillator units, or mixer units. This is, for instance, a mixer. I don't know that exactly, of course, but this is a mixer completely shielded on all sides, and everything in this circuit has to do with handling the high frequency and keep out disturbing other frequencies. So that's the reason why it's completely shielded. When I turn the knob here, you can see that the capacitor changes, and this capacitor is a part of a tank circuit. The tank circuit is here. That's this small piece of wire, and here and here. And so we tune in on very, very high frequencies. This is also a coil. Perhaps peculiar, but okay. That's the way it works. It's all related to the length from the wire and thus to the frequency. I don't have the formula for this calculation at hand, but you can find it on Wikipedia and the internet, etc., etc. So back again to this video, the aims of this video, to tell something about elementary coil properties. I didn't talk about the saturation. Perhaps I want to do that in the next video. I see on my camera that 12 minutes are passed, so that's a very long time. Choke coils, radio coils here. By inserting here ferrite rod, the frequency changes, goes down very, very substantially. And for this moment, that's all there is to tell about coils. Perhaps I'll make a new video in which I want to tell more about choke coils, filter coils, EF coils, etc.